like a shark in a shrimp tank. Big fish, small pawn in the shrimp tank. When it's take a swim, only option is to win.
And welcome to the Arkansas Shrimp Tank post-show wrap-up. I'm your host, Rich Jensen, along with my co-host, David Sims, and our special guest this week, Joel Johnson of PI Roofing. It's great having you on, Joel. You can always catch a replay on the entire podcast at arkansas.shrimptankpodcast.com. There's all sorts of great information in the podcast itself. I encourage you to go listen, because one of the things we talked about in the podcast was businesses failing or almost failing. And David, I think Joel had a pretty interesting story about that.
It was really a great story that you shared about coming through the Great Recession in 2007, 2008. Share with our listeners about that.
Sure. Well, we started in 2001. We started at zero. So by 2008, we were doing $11.7 million in revenue. So that's a feat in
its own. Tremendous growth, yeah.
Unfortunately, we lost $1 million that year just because we had more of a club atmosphere than really a business atmosphere. So that was a reason for that.
Mm. Club meaning that not so much that you're just all having a good time, but not really following a written business plan kind of thing.
Right. Just had a lot of people doing a lot of things, and we were not really making a lot of money.
Gotcha. Mm.
And they were spending a lot of stuff that they didn't really need to be spending money on.
You've also written a book. You have a copy of it here. Yep. I encourage you folks to take a look at this, because obviously it says, you know, the roof leak detective, but I like the subtitle, Never Pay for Another Roof Again. So
absolutely.
Tell our folks how this came out, why you wrote the book, and kind of some of the highlights of it.
Well, I wrote this in 2014. It gave me a few years after the big event that we had to try to put some thoughts down on paper. But the reason for never buying another roof again is if you're using a quality contractor, the shingles that we have these days are lifetime. Mm. They say limited lifetime or lifetime, but if you're using that type of material and you put it down right, why should you need another roof in your lifetime?
Sounds good to me, because literally I just had PI Roofing re-roof our house, and now I don't have to think about it again.
There it is.
Right?
I'm looking forward to my free roof, Joel.
Oh, free roof. Last roof.
It says never pay again. You have to pay the first time.
Oh, that's right. I just focused on free.
Free.
So you also talked on the podcast about that, you know, the reality is we as homeowners, we just don't know what we don't know, and how we can rely upon your firm as our expert to help us really understand what is the insurance company telling us when we make a claim. About that.
Yeah. The insurance companies remarkably replace a lot of roofs. I'm not sure what the statistic is, but there's a lot of roofs that get replaced by the insurance company. So one of the things that we like to do for our employees is take them on trips to see the Razorbacks play. Everybody likes to go to a Razorback football game, right?
Woo pig suey.
Yeah, absolutely. Sure. So one of our first times up there, Miss Beverly, I'm not sure if she told me, I think I had mentioned to her, because I'm always looking at ceilings.
And this is at the inn that you stay
in. At the inn at Bella Vista. I said, Miss Beverly, we've got a stain on your ceiling up here. And I said, can I please get on your roof? So after a little coercing, she allowed me to get up on her roof, was able to fix the roof leak, and then I was able to help her with an insurance claim. Mm. So unfortunately, when the first insurance estimate came back, it was only about $12,000. Mm. Now, this is an inn, 5 bedrooms. It's a pretty good-sized place.
Yeah.
So after about a year of helping her negotiate or work with the insurance adjuster on things that they missed, it was $82,000.
Wow. $82,000.
So that's a $70,000-something not knowing what you don't know. So
that's worth the price.
Exactly.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Hey, Joel, if someone wants to, one of the watchers or listeners of the podcast, want to get in touch with PI Roofing, either learn more or maybe even have an estimate or a leak detection done,
absolutely,
how would they get a hold of you?
Yeah. Well, you can go to our website, piroofing.com. We've got a Contact Us page. You can come by our office, 6109 Remount Road in North Little Rock. We've been there since 2005. Phone number, 501-687-6246. And we've got a couple email addresses, info@piroofing.com or roofguy@piroofing.com. Great ways to get in touch with us.
Well, again, thank you so much to Joel for coming on the Shrimp Tank. Next week, we're going to have an intrapreneur, meaning not someone who started a company but worked his way up to CEO of an international company that went through two private equity buyouts, I think it was, David. And so you won't want to miss that. And as always, if you missed any of the actual podcast itself, go to arkansas.shrimptankpodcast.com and listen to the entire thing and all the past episodes. And remember, to become a shark, we all start out as shrimp. I
I've been feeling like a shark in a shrimp tank.